get buried dead in the ground. Only Bob had passed. Bob goes to the box. Box goes in the ground. The problem is Bob's box might just have a little bit of buoyancy. The Bob goes to the box with buoyancy in the bowl. It rains in the bowl. Bob can bob up. Yeah. So our first burial goes in the ground by the river in the French Quarter. The highest ground we have is used for burials. Because in 1718, we are a few dozen Canadian convicts, and that's it. City grows, port grows, population grows, and then we burn. Spain rebuilds the city in Spain, gives us our first above ground tomb. Uh-huh. And the best thing about the above ground tomb, Bob's already up. Bob can't bob up. Now we can use land here in the middle, dead center. You can move our center. And this will allow us to free up the highest ground for the important stuff. The way this works, the church owns the land. They put out streets and street names. They sell lots with lot numbers. What we call it is 119. It's purchased by Jules Bernard. Jules hires a builder, hires an architect. Things like stone, iron, space display well. Some very well. If you can, like, even design the tombs to mimic their houses. Fancy. Most tombs, they call their front nameplate. They call that, the church calls it, the enclosure tablet. Most have a threaded stud, little bolt that goes in. This one's actually got a dowel that runs through it. You kind of see the plate. It's actually in, so this one's pretty fancy. So on the inside, they're all the same. There's a shelf in the middle. It goes throughout, creating two vaults, bottom top. First version, Tad and Lester. Lester goes to the box. Box and Lester. Bottom shelf, slide them in. Family leaves. They're important. Brick it. The side of the place is his name. 20 years to the day have gone by. We've lost George, there's the box, top shelf, slide him in, family leaves, you record it, Rick it, the sign is placed in his name. Now it's gonna go a little tricky about 2 years later. We've lost our poor aunt, Nancy. So the question has to become, where does Nancy go? And now the whole point of this kind of burial is to speed natural decomposition. Catholic and cremated, go to hell. Mother Nature does it, totally fine. What do you say in Texas? Low and slow, huh?
Yeah.
So, no shade here, very little shade. Box in the sun, same height of latitude as Cairo, Egypt. On the hottest summer days, these are pushing 100 C. It's like 230 Fahrenheit. They're made to get hot. After 22 years, Lester's done. And once we have a need, we call the church, hey, there's Gary, up with the Bernard family, bringing Dotsie on Tuesday. Here's my credit card number. Now, on Tuesday morning, the cemetery crew comes out, before the family gets here. Undertaker, facade comes off. Records tell us that Lester, the bottom shelf, has been the longest. Take out the brick, pull out the box of Lester, make way to the box of Dotsie. What do you do with Lester? Yeah. Being Catholic means you've got to stay on consecrated ground. You're going to open the box, take what's left of the blaster.